Special night it is to be here at the Charles V building in the Alhambra, Granada, Spain. And indeed, it's a great privilege to be able to perform in this monument. This whole journey of mine, my infatuation with the Celts, has not been just a musical journey, but in many ways it's been a journey of self-discovery. So a great part of this evening's performance is a kind of musical travel writing that documents a lot of that path of discovery. This next piece is probably one of the earliest pieces I learned in the more overtly Irish Celtic repertoire. It is a piece that comes from the west coast of Ireland. The lyrics were written by a man called Padraic Colum, although the melody is traditional. And you can still hear some of the Eastern influences in this melody, and it's called She Moved Through the Fair. Thank you. The Irish poet W.B. Yeats was seen by many as a great inspiration of the resurgence of Irish nationalism at the turn of the 20th century, as he captured and recaptured the mythology and folklore of Ireland. So this is a magical piece called The Stolen Child.
Rocky Highland of Sleuthwood in the lake,
leafy island where flapping herons wake. The drowsy water rats that we've hid our furry flats, full of berries and of reddest stolen cherries. Come I, a human child, to the waters and the Some on the shadows there, and tie a ribbon on the sheltering arms in the springtime of the year. The songs of the birds seem to fill the wood, but when the fiddler plays, all their voices can be heard long past their woodland days. In circles and in rows, and so the journey of the night descends when all the shades are gone. A garland gay we bring you here, and at your door we stand. It hears the sprout well budded out, the work of our Lord's hand. This song takes me much further down the line of the history of the Celts. When I first discovered that they attempted to sack Delphi in Greece somewhere around 275, that seemed to open a door for me to explore Homer's Ulysses, particularly from Penelope's point of view. This song reflects upon those who sometimes go away and we're waiting and waiting for them to come back. Thank you. just they walk by the river spring. Hee hee ha, bunny hill, the owls push the youngest in, the swan swims a bunny hill. Oh, father, but daddy, he swims a swan. Gentlewoman, the swan swims a bonny hoo. He led her on the bank to dry. He heard me bonny hill. There came a harper passing by. The swan swims a bonny hoo. December of 1995 that I decided that I would take the train across Siberia. Also during that trip, I was reading Dante's Inferno. And it was quite interesting, the fusion of these two experiences, because Russia was going through such a transformation and a very challenging and difficult one. And a lot of what I was seeing outside the window was desperation and discomfort that comes with all that those kinds of changes. This is a piece that was born out of that experience. It's called Dante's Prayer. When the dark wood fell before me, and all the paths were overgrown, when the peace of Christ said there is no other way, I tilled the sorrows of stone. I did not believe because I could not see, though you came to me in the night. When the dawn seemed forever lost, you showed me your love. On the ocean, cast your soul to the sea. When the dark night seems endless, please remember me. When the mountain fell before me, by the deep well of desire, from the fountain of forgiveness, beyond the ice and the fire, cast your eyes on the ocean, cast your soul to the sea. When the dark night seems endless, please remember. Thank you.
setting sun or rolling waves at sea, a gentle breeze or lightning in a storm, a dancing dream of all eternity. The sand was shimmering in the morning light, and dancing off the tunes of fall. As we set out to the desert's cry,
thank you.
Thank you. We often think of these times as times that we've become much more aware of the environment and the climate and so on. So it was with some surprise that about 14 years ago or so, I came across this traditional piece that, although it laments the demise of a particular handsome tree in northern part of Ireland, it seems to capture a sentiment that is broader in scope in terms of the decimation of the forest. This is a traditional piece called Bonnie Portmore. In 1988, I found myself in Dublin working on a production at the Abbey Theatre. It was in May, and I just remember those beautiful, beautiful evenings as I cycled back to my bed and breakfast. And one of the roads that I would come by would be a rather famous road called Raglan Road, in which this next piece is entitled. The lyrics were written by a wonderful Irish poet by the name of Patrick Kavanagh.
Ooh.
around and around to drums that pulse out at concept darkness, moving to the pagan sound. Somewhere in a hidden memory, images float before my eyes. A fragrant nights of stroke and a bonfire's dancing till the next sunrise. I can see the lights in the distance, trembling in the dark cloak of night. Candles and lanterns and dancing, dancing, oh, all so long, all so night holds the holy bush to mark where the old year passes by. I can see the lights in the distance, trembling in the dark cloak of night. Candles and lanterns are dancing, dancing, all so long, all so many people who've immersed themselves in some corner of Celtic history or literature, it's impossible to avoid, not that one would want to, the Arthurian legends. So with that, I gravitated to this poem of Alfred Tennyson's and set it to music, and this is called The Lady of Shalott. Thank you. Up and down the people go, gazing where the lilies blow. Round an island there below, the island of Shalott. A bushel from her bower heaves, he rode between the barley sheaves. The sun came dazzling through the leaves, it flamed upon the brazen greaves of Bull Sir Lancelot. A Red Cross knight forever kneeled to a lady in his shield, and sparkled on the yellow field beside. She made three paces through the room. She saw the water lily bloom. She saw the helmet and the plume. She looked to Camelot. Out flew the web and floated wide. The mirror cracked from side to side. The curse has come upon me, cried the lady. Stormy east wind straining, the pale yellow woods were waning. The broad stream in his banks complaining, heavily the low sky raining over towered Camelot. And down she came and found a boat beneath the willow left afloat. And round about the she wrote, the Lady of Shalott. Who is this and what is he? In the light at Badlands near, died the scent of royal cheer, and they crossed themselves for fear, the knights at Camelot. Lancelot mused a little space. He said she has a lovely face. God in his mercy lent her grace, the Lady of Shalott.
Coast of God.
the tune, 'twas a vision before me. We left the music behind as the dance carried on, as we stole away to the seashore and smelled the brine, felt the wind in our hair. In sadness you passed, suddenly I knew that you'd have to go. Your world was not mine, your eyes told me so. Yet it was there, I felt the crossroads of time, and I wondered why. As we cast our gaze on the tumbling sea, a vision came o'er me. Of thundering hooves and beating wings in the clouds above. Turning to go, heard you call out my name. You're like a bird in a cage, spreading its wings to fly. The old wizard lost, you sang as you flew.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. In Shakespeare's play, Cymbeline, he focuses in on the period of time when the Romans have arrived in England and they're pressing on to the remnants of the Celts. So I'd like to leave the last word to Shakespeare.
And come.